वंदे गुरुपद्द्वंद्वं भक्तबिंदसमन्वितं श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नित्यानंदसहोदितं श्रीनंदनंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदयं गोपीजन समायुक्तं बिंदावनं वाचाकुवश कृपा सिंधुवच पतिता पावनेभ्य वैष्णवभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं हृतगिरिं यत्कृपा तमहं वंदे परमानंदमाधवं वृंदावई तुलसीदेव वै पिया वै केशव सच कृष्णभक्ति पदे देवी सत्वभत्वई नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीर संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेश गौरी पत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरु भक्ति युक्त सदानुर भक्ति पुमरक्तं हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे आजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकाबुदात् संकीर्तनैकपितरो कमलायताक्ष विश्वाम्बरो द्विजवरो जुगधर्मपालो वंदे जगत्प्रियकरो करुणाभुतार हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वंदितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यम् भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानां बागीशजस्य वदने लक्ष्मीर्यस्वतभक्ति यस्यास्ति हृदये संवितं नृसिंहमहं भजे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे यस्यास्ति भक्तिर्भगवति अकिंचना सर्वगुणैस्तत्र समासते सुरा हरो अभक्तस्य कुतो महद्गुणा मनोरथेन सतो धवतो वही यस्यास्ति भक्तिर्भगवति अकिंचना सर्वगुणैस्तत्र समासते सुरा हरो अभक्तस्य कुतो महद्गुणा मनोरथेन सतो धवतो वही। गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति सिसिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु told in this human life Harivajan is a must. Luckily we have this human life, and this human life is very rare. Next life there is no surety that we can take human birth, there is no surety, so we cannot take rest. Birth after birth you are wasting our time. Life is very unstable, and this human life though it is unstable, but still can give perfect meaning. Perfect meaning means we can get Krishna Prema, Bhagavad Bhakti, this life. Manusya marthadam anittam api hadhiram turunam jateta patita na manubhitti yavat. This sloka, we'll have to think. Though the human life is also unstable, but still is meaningful. Because in life, in this life, we can get Krishna Bhakti. So while we are alive, very quickly, without wasting time, we'll have to try our best. Under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava, we'll have to try our best to attain bhakti. These human beings, they thinking themselves, we are Brahman, we are Kshatriya, we are Vaishya, Shudra, Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, Sannyasi, totally different kind of, it is one kind of false ego. Varnasam Dharma is effective up to that point. Which point? If we have false ego, Varnasam Dharma can stand. After we attain Paramahansa Dharma, Paramahansa stage, this Varnasam Dharma is useless. Naham Vipa, Nacha, Narapatira, Napi, Vaishya, Nasudra, Naham, Burni, Nacha, Gyapatira, Nabhamsa, Tirva, Kintu Paddan Nikila Paramananda, Kintu Paddan Nikila Paramananda, Purnamitadhir, Gopi Bhartur, Padakamalaya, Dasa, Dasa, Anudasa. Mahaprabhu teaching us. We are eternal servant and Bhagavan, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking. Those who are going to express false ego, they can never utter Harinam. Those who have false ego, me and mine conception, they can never utter Harinam. Harinam cannot come. Sevan mukhehi yuvaya madhu swayameva spuriti adho. We are discussing Bhagavatam, Bihad Bhagavatam Mrita, that the Brahman was exhibiting his duty, karma upon everything there, according to Varnasam Dharma he was following in Allahabad, Triveni Sangam. But this cannot give absolute bhakti, pure bhakti not possible. I was discussing that day. We are all averse to Krishna. That's why it is impossible for us to avoid false ego. It is impossible to avoid false ego, to do actual Hari Bhajan. Quite impossible. Actually, Hari is present everywhere, but we cannot see. Hari is present everywhere, but we cannot see. Those who are following Varnasam Dharma, they are also final goal is to attain Bhagavan. If they are trying properly, then they can come successful, otherwise not. Varnasam Dharma ultimately cannot give pure bhakti, not possible. We know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, Jive Sarupai Krishna Nitya Das. We learn from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Addo ba abdo satante ba mrittur vai praninam dhuba. Addo ba abdo satante ba mrittur vai praninam dhuba. In 10th canto, Vasudevi Maharaj speaking, death is inevitable. There is no solution of this death. It's inevitable. I was also speaking that Atma is Chetan Vastu, body is matter, Prakriti. Prakriti and Purush staying for infinity period, for long time they are staying together. That is why the property of Chetan Vastu going to be translated into Jada Vastu in our Prakriti. And though Chetan Vastu Atma, but still the inert property of Prakriti going to be translated into, you know, Jiva. Actually, it cannot touch the pure Chidatma, but still, for a long time, they are going to exchange. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving example, how possible? We have no connection with this material world. We have no connection with this material world. But still we discover we have 100% connection with this material world. Everything material, our conception, our mind, everything, all material. We cannot do away with matter. Matter is a must. But whereas Shastra speaking, we have no connection with the material world. Unknowingly, Jivatma, due to Maya, going to discover relationship with Prakriti. Mahaprabhu giving an example to Sanatana Gosai. If one iron piece I am going to keep inside fire, glowing fire, then shortly that the iron piece, black iron piece can take the form of fire. And that iron piece, if I now use for burning something, I can use it. But originally, when the iron piece was there, black piece, that originally iron piece is cold, black, iron property, you know. It cannot, this iron piece cannot help me to burn anything. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was thinking, though the iron is black and it's cold, no requests, but still, when we keep this iron piece inside fire, that the fire going to enter into that iron piece and going to show the property of fire. Actually, iron itself cannot exhibit the power of fire. But the fire going to enter into that iron piece, so now we can utilize that iron piece to burn, to for burning something. So Prakriti and Purush, Purush mean, Purush, two type of Purush you can find. One is Paramatma, Parampurush. Purush, two type of Purush. One is Parampurush, Bhagavan, Paramatma, Parampurush, and another Purush, Jivatma. Now Jivatma Chinmay, Jivatma Chinmay has no connection with this material world still. For infinity pure bonded soul, Jivatma staying with Prakriti matter, and as if unknowingly this property of nature, Prakriti going to, you know, enter. Actually cannot touch Chidatma, but still it seems due to Maya, misconception. And the Chetan Dharma also for long time staying with all Chetan, Ishavasyamidam, Ishavasyami, Atmavasyamidam Sarvam. We can think from Bhagavatam, Ishavasyamidam Sarvam Yatkinchi Jagatam, it is Ishopanishad sloka. But if we discuss same sloka almost, Atmavasyamidam Sarvam Yatkinchi Jagatam Jagat. Whole world, there is full of Atma, we cannot see. Atma invisible, we cannot see. Nayam atma pravachanena labhya, na medhaya na bahu na sritena, jam eva esa tena labhya, tasai shesha vibhinuti tonu samam. It is written in Upanishad, we know. So actually, this atma, we very complicated, we cannot understand about this chetan vastu, atma vastu, we cannot understand. Atma Vastu, Chetan Vastu, inconceivable, we cannot understand. We cannot understand until and unless we are going to take shelter unto the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnav. By the power of Guru Vaishnav, then we can understand. Otherwise, by personal effort, we cannot understand. Impossible. By personal effort, we can never understand. Impossible. By personal effort, Chetan Vastu, Atma Vastu can never be known. That's why it is written, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Prahlad Maharaj is going to speak that Naishang Mati Stavaturukramhangi. Nayam Atma Pauchana Nelba, I already told, it is about Atma Vastu. We cannot understand Atma Vastu. If that Paramatma going to accept us, then we can understand. Nayam Atma Pauchana Nelba, Medhaya, if you have a very fine brain you have, you can pass lecture, you can read so many things, no, you are hearing so many harikas, but still, cannot understand. If by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, this Atma Vastu, Bhagavan going to accept you, then and only then can manifest his own secret sarup in front of you. This is the only procedure. And Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Naishang Mati Stavat Urukramanging Sprishatyanarthapagamo Yathar Jadartha Mahi Asam Padurajo Vishekam Niskinchananam Nabrinito Javat. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Na Eshang Mati. This mind, or material mind, can never touch the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Naishang Mati Stavat Urukramanging Sprishati. Anarthapagamo Yadartho. To clean our anartho, to clear all anartho inside our heart, we'll have to take birth by the dust particle from the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava. Mahi asam pada rajovisekam, niskinchan anam na brinituj niskinchan. Niskinchan means he has no idea, no second concentration, only one concentration onto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Ditya Abhinivesh is not there. No second concentration, nothing there. Only is thinking about Supreme Lord. The lotus feet of Supreme Lord, he is his only property. A pure Guru Vaishnava is Niskinjan because the lotus feet of Supreme Lord is the only property. They think. Naishang Mati Stava Durukramanghi. Sprishatta anarthabhagamo yadattho mahi asampadarajyobhisekam niskinchananam na brinito javat. We cannot understand, we cannot touch the lotus feet of Supreme Lord or this material mind. Narottama Thakur many times speaking in Kirtan speaking, Vaishnavera padadhuli tahe mor snan keli. Vaishnavera padadhuli, the dust particle from the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava is our only treasure, sampatti. We can take bath. There is our only support. Vaishnavera padadhuli tahe mor snan keli. Prahlad, actually, Narottama Thakur Maharaj speaking. And also, we know that Rupa Goswami Pad going to show us Adadanam Srinam Dante Iridam Yache Punaha Punaha. We know Raghunath Goswami speaking. Adadanam Trinam Dante Iridam Yache Punaha Punaha Simad Rupa Padambuja Dhuli Sang Janmajan. The only target of Rupanuga devotee, they expect the dust particle from the lotus feet of Rupa Goswami Pad. They want nothing. Only they want Adadanam Trinam Dantai, taking straw in teeth repeatedly. We are requesting the dust particle from the lotus feet of Rupa Goswami Pad. That is our only target, nothing else. Only target, it is our only target. So the sloka I started with is very Mahaprabhu going to teach us that we will have to grow our enduring power just like a tree. Tararopi sahishnuna. Just like a tree can bear everything, not asking any water, suffering sunlight, everything, not going to request us for protection, nothing. Tararopi sahishnuna. Just like tree, we like to grow our enduring power. Just like tree, we like to grow our enduring power, so that we can sing the glories of Supreme Lord. Trinadu Visunijana Tararubi Sveshana Amanena Manandino Kirtaniyo Sadahuri. Then and only then we can sing the glories of Supreme Lord, sing the glories of Guru Vaishnava. We can hear, we can digest everything. Then we can digest everything. Then and only then we can. Jasasti bhaktir bhagati aginchana. I was speaking just before I was starting. Jasasti bhaktir bhagavati aginchana sarva guni sattva samasati suraha. Haru abhakta sakuto mahadguna maha manorathin asato dhavato bhi. Jasasti bhaktir bhagavati aginchana. Those who are having akinchana bhakti, follow. Naishang mati stava durukka may you speak already sing. Jasasti bhaktir bhagavati akinchana. He who is having this kind of akinchana bhakti, jasasti bhaktir bhagavati akinchana, sarva gunis tattva samasati suraha. All demigods going to take rest there. Inside the heart of that, those who are following akinchana bhakti. Yasasti bhaktir bhagavati akinchana sarva gunis tatra samasate sura harau abhakta sakuto mahadguna. Harau abhakta sa, if we find some non-devotee, not devotee, he cannot have all those transcendental qualities which we can expect inside a heart of pure devotees. Yasasti bhaktir bhagavati akinchana sarva gunis tatra samasate suraha harau abhakta sakuto mahadguna. There is no possibility that a material man having no devotional practice, we cannot expect nice quality, transcendental quality in them. Because that jivatma, his mind, sitting on this mind, material mind, mind is compared with one chariot. Manorathino asata. Because actually, we can go anywhere sitting in this chariot. Mind is compared with chariot. That mind can go anywhere and everywhere within fraction of second. Manorathino asato dhavato bhai. Asat. As we are having material concentration, in material things, always their mind is fickle mind, unstable mind, chanchal, always here and there they can run. Manorathena asato dhavato bhai. They are sitting in their material mind and can go anywhere they can lie. Anywhere. In Bhagavatam we say, they can travel anywhere in this panchal khetra. Panchal means Punjab. Panchal actually means Punjab. But here meaning is there. Shabdo, sparsho, rupa, ras, gandho. Five different kinds of enjoying elements. Shabdo, sparsho, rupa, ras, gandho. Panchatan matra. Shabdo, sparsho, rupa, ras, gandho. The bonded soul can ride the chariot of mind, material mind, and go anywhere they like. Big problem. In Vyad Bhagavatamrita, we are going to see the comparative statement. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I was discussing in Hindi Katha also, so many disturbances in Hari Katha. is the arrangement of Maya. Maya going to stop. I was also feeling disturbance. What to do? Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking that we are going to apply our material brain, mind, rationality to understand a sadhu. That's why we cannot see any sadhu. In this material world, Jagannath going to arrange sadhu sangha. In this material world, Jagannath going to arrange sadhu sangha for us. But we cannot see. Because we have material brain, material conception, material rationality. On the basis of this, we want to measure a sadhu. Estimate. We want to understand he is sadhu, he is not, he is sadhu, this way to understand. That's why we cannot see any sadhu. Big problem. Also, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is speaking that due to our kapat bhav, sometime we can come, we can come to meet with sadhu. By chance we can meet a pure sadhu, but still we cannot understand. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is speaking, this is because kapat bhav. Due to our kapat bhav, we cannot understand a sadhu. Due to our kapat bhav, we cannot understand a pure sadhu. Who is sadhu, who is not, we cannot understand. That is the main problem. Who is sadhu, who is not, we cannot understand. Big problem. So long as we have kapat bhav inside your heart, we cannot meet with one sadhu. Or if we at all meet, we cannot understand. Because of our kapat bhav, I know. So anyway, we will have to attain the pure sadhu. For satsanga, we will have to be sure. That is sadhu sangha. We have to be very sure about sadhu sangha. But Prabhupada speaking, those who are having false ego inside their heart, kam, krodh, lobh, moha, madha, mascharjo, jealousy, this kind of preacher we can find everywhere. Prabhupada speaking, if we are going to meet such a preacher, then in infinity period, if you go on doing this kind of sadhu sangha, you cannot get hari bhakti. Prabhupada speaking, kam, krodh, lobh, moha, madha, mascharjo, jealousy, everything, all different kind of disease there inside the heart of such a preacher who is going to preach. Such a preacher can speak Harikatha, cannot arrange Mangal, cannot arrange personal benefit, cannot arrange benefit for you also, cannot arrange. Prabhupada speaking, such a preacher if you attain Harikatha, then you can never get Krishna Bhakti. Only Niskinchan Bhakta you will have to hear Harikatha. Niskinchan anam na binito yabat prahladma already to, then and only then you can get, then and only then you can get the chance to attain bhakti. Otherwise there is no possibility. Material scientists, they are speaking that the dust particle, just now I was speaking, na? Simad rupa padambuja dhuli sang janma janmani. We want to be the dust particle from the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. Simad rupa padambuja dhuli sang janma janmani, we are speaking. Now about dust particle, we know that material scientist speaking, due to dust particle in the air, we are going to get moderate sunlight, moderate, suitable sunlight. Due to dust particle there in the air, due to dust particle present in the air, we are going to get suitable sunlight, moderate sunlight. If dust particle is not there in the air, then either sunlight going to scorchy sunlight going to kill us unbearable, or there would have a shadow. on this earth. We can see the whole sky is blue in color. We can see the sky, open sky is blue, because dust particle can only reflect blue color, blue. The dust particle up and up, when you go up, they are in very fine form dust particle there. If you go up and up, so up, then in fine form this dust particle is there. Those dust particle going to catch sunlight and going to reflect only blue color. That's why we can see whole sky is blue. Follow. The dust particle going to arrange cloud. Without dust particle, we cannot get cloud, we cannot get rain, everything. Also, we should compare with this Sadhu Sangha, how in the material world, transcendental world, material scientist going to give this example, we can compare it, we can get the exact picture in this transcendental world. Those who are going to think themselves as a dust particle from the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, for them it is very, very important, because without Guru Vaishnava, dust particle, those dust particle from the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, we can never understand Krishna Surya. Material scientists giving the example of material sun, material sun god there. But here, if we can compare with, if Guru Vaishnava is not there, if the dust particle from the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava not there going to help us, then it would not have been possible for us to get the kripa of Krishna Surya. Impossible. Paramahansa Sridhar Goswami used to give one example, very nice example. There is lotus feet in a lake. Padma name is Pankaja, Padma, lotus flower. Padma going to get the help of sunlight. Padma fool, there is in the lake there is water, and the lotus flower is there. When sun going to give, you know, sunlight, then Padma fool can gradually can manifest, you know, into full fledged form, can get manifested in full fledged form, Padma fool. That sunlight can kill that Padma lotus flower. If that lotus flower not going to take the support of that water, then the scorching sunlight going to kill that Padma. So under the guidance of Guru Vaishnava, if we are going to take the help of Guru Vaishnava, that can be compared with water in the lake. We are resting. In that case, Padma, I mean the Guru Vaishnava, Guru Vaishnava, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, the kripa of Guru Vaishnava is compared with the lake of the water of the lake, supporting which that Padma going to manifest, going to get manifested, and sunlight is compared with Krishna, and the Padma compared with the disciple. Disciple can get the kripa of Krishna Sun, Krishna Surya, provided going to get the support of Guru Vaishnava. Otherwise, that Krishna Sun cannot protect. Be careful. This example is given, very important, and also we know from Chandogya Upanishad, Chyamam Chavalam Prapadde, Chavalat Chyamam Prapadde. Chandogya Upanishad we find, Chyama Chavalam Prapadde. And Chabalat Chamam Prabhati, Cham means Sam, Sham Sundar. Cham means Chamam Chabalam Prabhati, Chabalat Chamam Prabhati. Follow. Krishna Shakti Sarup Chabal, Krishna Sarup Shakti, name is Chabal. Under the shelter of Krishna Sarup Shakti, Ladini Shakti Sar, and by sheltering the Bhava, Ladini Shakti Samayata Sar, Asray, can reach Krishna. Separately cannot reach. Chama Chabalam Prapadde, Chabalat Chamam Prapadde, it is written. Now point is there, in Bhagavad Bhagavatamrita, main point is that humble attitude. Main point is that humble attitude. If there is no humble attitude, I am a big preacher, I am the acharya, big, you know, all over the world, this kind of false ego can kill the preacher like Ravan, Kumbhakarna, compared with Ravan, Hiranyakasipu. Ravan fall full of false ego. Prabhupada speaking, Ravan cannot reach. Ravan can never cross Viraja. Due to false ego, cannot cross Viraja to enter the transcendental world. But the dust particle of Guru Vishnu, dust particle from the lotus feet of Guru Vishnu, can help us to cross Viraja, Brahmalok, everything. We can reach Parabrahma, is everything possible by the keeper of Guru Vishnu. Main thing, humble attitude. Main thing is humble attitude. If there is no, we are discussing for a long time, that Brahman, you know, Naraji Maharaj going to appreciate that Brahman there in Triveni Sangam, Allahabad, and the Brahman going to request Naraji Maharaj, you are appreciating me. I am not enjoying the kripa of Vishnu, Mahavishnu. No, you can go to South India. You can discover there that the king is very, very full of bhakti. You can go. You can go there and see yourself. Follow. Because the king going to arrange all Bhagavat Prasadam for everybody, those who are beggars, sannyasis, everybody, for all those who are coming, free of cost. And going to offer bhoga everything, going to do Guru Arati, and in front of Vishnu, because everywhere, in his temple, almost everywhere there is temple of Vishnu, full of temple. Especially in his kingdom, he is going to worship Vishnu and going to offer bhoga, raga, everything, all nice thing, and going to dance in front of deity, tashagre, vividhair nama gatha, sankirtanair sayam, nitan dibyani gitani gayan, badyani vadayan. In front of that deity, Vishnu deity, he is going to, you know, sing and dance and play musical instrument, everything, mridanga, everything. And bhatri bharja sutvai, poutrair, vrittvam, vritta amatta purohitvai, purohit, the priest, you know, amatta, those who are helping to run the kingdom, minister, everything, everybody, brothers, wife, all children, I mean the boys and daughter, everything, father, mother, going to dance. Together, all together. Bhatri, Bharya, Sutvai, Potrai, ग्रैंड सॉम सॉम गैंस ऑल वृत्तो सर्वेंट्स अमात्य पुरोहित अन्वेश्वजन अन्वेश्व ऑल अदर सज्जन रिलेटिव्स सज्जन स्वाकम स्वाकम मीन टुगेदर विथ ऑल टुगेदर विथ देम इज गोइंग टू डांस एंड सिंग एंड प्ले एवरीथिंग इज गोइंग टू डू डिवोशनल एक्टिविटीज टू सैटिस्फाई सुप्रीम लॉर्ड ते ते तस्सो गुण व्रत कृष्ण भक्तानुवर्तिन संख्यातुम कति कथते ज्ञायन्ते कति वा माया ट्रूली स्पीकिंग दैट किंग एस वेरी नाइस नाइस क्वालिटीज दिस किंग द किंग एज वेरी वेरी नाइस 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 क्वालिटीज आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड ना सर्वगुणेश तत्व समासते सुरा इज अ डिबोटी सो नेचुरली ऑल नाइस नाइस क्वालिटीज देयर इनसाइड द हार्ट ऑफ दैट किंग ट्रूली स्पीकिंग द किंग इज हैविंग सो नाइस नाइस क्वालिटीज विच इज जस्ट फेवरेबल फॉर कृष्ण भक्ति दर काउंटलेस क्वालिटीज दैट ब्राह्मण आई मीन ब्राह्मण स्पीकिंग टू नारदजी आई कैन नॉट यू नो हाउ मेनी आई कैन काउंट काउंटलेस क्वालिटीज देयर आई कैन नॉट स्पीक आई हैव नो कैपेसिटी टू स्पीक दिस वे एक्चुअली व्हेन दैट ब्राह्मण गोइंग टू एप्रिसिएट अबाउट द किंग देयर यू नो फॉलो देन परीक्षित गोइंग टू स्पीक ततो निपवरम द्रष्टुम टू सी दैट टू सी टू मीट दैट किंग परीक्षित महाराज डोंट ट्राई टू मिस योर ट्रैक दिस भागवत अमृतो हु स्पीकिंग परीक्षित महाराज स्पीकिंग टू हिज मदर उत्तरा दिस टॉपिक्स was long ago this katha was done now Janmijaya going to hear from Jaimini follow now this inside this text Brahman going to speak is compiled by Sanatan Goswami so don't try to miss the track if you miss that again and understand what is happening now here Parikshit Maharaj speaking to mother Uttara that after hearing so much glories of that king of south indian king Narad ji maharaj took decision to meet the king so Parikshit maharaj speaking tato nipavaram drashtum tad desh narado brajan narad going to reach that you know south india tato nipavaram drashtum to see that Great king, tato nipavaram drashtum. Nipavaram mean, varam mean actually very nice quality, very nice, highly honorable. Bara, varam means sreshto, high class. Tato nipavaram drashtum to see tad deshe narada brajan. Narada already started, gone there. Deva puja sabha shaktyastatro. तत्रैक्षत प्रजा वेन नारदजी गोइंग टू एंटर हिज किंगडम ही डिस्कवर रियली सो व्हाट ब्राह्मण टोल्ड इज रियली ट्रू देव पूज सभासक्तस्तत्रो तत्रैक्षत प्रजा ऑल द कंट्रीमैन दे आर बिजी विद वर्शिपिंग देवा एंड ऑलवेज दे आर लाफिंग एंजॉयिंग मी दे आर यू नो वेरी हैप्पी Because they are going to worship Devata. They are worshipping everywhere refined temple. Harsena Badayan Binam. Naraji Maharaj having one musical instrument playing all the time. Guitar. Harsena Badayan Bina. Rajadhanim गतो अधिकम विप्रोक्ताद ओपि विप्रोक्ताद ओपि संपसन संगम उवाचो तम निपम नारदजी महाराज what all नारदजी महाराज heard from that Brahman, now watching it is more than that. Narji Maharaj watching it is more than that. That's why, very with loving mood, very happily, Harsena Badayam Bina, by praying this Bina, Razdhani Gato Dhikam, Razdhani Gato, is gone to get that king and to enter that kingdom. And adhikam vipraktad ofi, what he heard from that Brahman is more than that. Sangpaksam, he started watching, is yeah, really so, is more than that. Sangam vacho tvam nipram. Naraji Maharaj wanted to reach that king, going to meet the king, and Naraji Maharaj going to glorify that king personally. Naraji Maharaj vacho tvam krishna kipa patram jasidrik rajya vaibhavam salloko guno dharmartho gyan bhakti vir annitam. Naraji Maharaj speaking directly to that king. Ho Rajan, tvam, you krishna kipa patram, you are enjoying the kipa of Krishna. Tvam krishna kipa patram jase drig rajya vaibhavam, who is having this kind of opulences in the kingdom. Oh my God! And all by the help of those opulences you are going to worship, going to satisfy Supreme Lord. Oh my God! All your money, opulence, everything you are utilizing, manpower, money power, all everything you are utilizing. That's why Naraji Maharaj going to appreciate. Naraji Maharaj glorifying, O King, tvam krishna kipa patram, you are really Krishna Kipa Patra. You are really enjoying the Kipa of Vishnu, Krishna. Tvam Sri Krishna Kipa Patram Jasedrik Jasho Jar. You are having this kind of opulences in your kingdom. And with the help of those opulences, you are serving Supreme Lord. You are trying to satisfy Supreme Lord. Salloko Guno Dharmartho Jnana. All. You know, follow. Rajya Vaibhav, Sadharma Nirata. I was discussing about what is Sadharma for guest, for Varnasan Dharma. I was discussing everything, you can remember. Everything. Sadharma Nirata, this is Sadharma form. Try to understand. That was the sadharma for that Brahman in Allahabad. And that is the sadharma for this Brahman, for this king. Follow, sadharma. Sadharma Nirata Praja, and he is going to follow his sadharma. Sadharma. And all subjects, I mean those who are countrymen staying, they are also, you know, going to follow the king. And king having affection for all, you know, countrymen, lok vatsalladi gunogram, and dharma artho gyan bhakti dara susovito vaibhav samo vardhaman. Salloko guna dharma, salloko mane? Salloko guna dharma, yeah, you know. Satloko guna dharma gyan bhakti vir annitam. Full of nice qualities. Yasasti bhakti bhagavati akinchana sarvagunis tattva samasate suraha. Akinchana bhakti. But now the king is not having akinchana bhakti. He is going to show only sadharma. But to establish this comparative statement, we are discussing that all the appearances of this kingdom, and all praja subject, those are countrymen, they are also busy with their sadharma. You are also feeling for, you know, having a tremendous affection for the countrymen. On all dharma, artho, gyan, bhakti, dara, susobita, all decorated with all nice, nice qualities. Nice, nice vaibhav. So, Naraji Maharaj going to appreciate Dharma means you are going to allow, you are going to allow free prasadam for all beggars, on, you know, sannyasis, brahmacharis, those who are going to a country. You are going to sabhikkhuk pravidhika annadi dandi sadharmajita. Artho bhagavat pujadi, to arrange bhagavat pujadi you need money. Artho bhai, you are going to spend money. Or seva kamuna, you have your desire to serve Supreme Lord. That's all reserved. You are not going to misuse it. Try to understand. In Prayag, that Tribeni Sangam, that Vipra, that Brahman, Sadharma Acharan he was following. By the help of Sadharma Acharan, he was following Sadharma. Niskam Vishnu Bhakti Saddha Rupa, he is Saddha, Saddha Sadhan, you know. Saddha means Niskam Vishnu Bhakti ke Saddha. His target was Niskam Vishnu Bhakti, but the Sadhan is this. You are following Sadharma properly, going to worship and dance, taking birth in, you know, in the confluence of Ganga Jamuna Saraswati, going to arrange all nice things, a salgram going to offer, going to distribute among, after the residue going to take. Follow, you see. By Sarup, it is not Suddha Bhakti. By Sarup, it is not actually Suddha Bhakti, it is Karma Mishra. It is Karma Mishra Bhakti. But Arop Siddha Bhakti, Arop means attributed. It is not actually bhakti, it is like bhakti. Karma Mishra is Karma Mishra Bhakti and Arop, it is attributed. So Arop Siddha Bhakti means Arop Siddha Bhakti, it is attributed, it is like bhakti. It is like bhakti, not actually bhakti. But though it is not by Sarup, it is not bhakti, but still some Baba Bhakti attributed here. So Niskam Varnasam Dharmo Nishtavan Brahman, he is Nishtavan Brahman. That Brahman is very efficacy, very nice. So if one Brahman Niskam going to follow Varnasam Dharma Nishtavan Brahman, so he can get Shuddha Bhakti, not that. Follow what I say. He has no desire. He is going to do Niskam, Varnasam Dharma, going to follow. He is Nishtavan, having some everything Nishtha, you know, Nishtha stability, is all etiquette, everything is following. That doesn't mean he is Brahman going to follow Niskam, Varnasam Dharma, so he can get Shuddha Bhakti. Not that. Not that. Follow. Jiva Goswami was speaking, Varna sama charetvadikam agyato diro sadhyam suddho bhaktyan adhik adhikarinaha pratyabhyoktamiti bhavam. Those who are having no solid firm belief and faith, for them Varna Samacharavatam, this sloka was discussed. If they are going to follow Varnasam Dharma in toto, and by chance if they are going to meet with Suddha Bhakta, then they can get kripa from them, then they can get Suddha Bhakti, not before that. Follow. And here is one very spectacular thing, that here in Allahabad, Tribeni Sangam, he was pure Brahman. His etiquette was very nice. Faith, strong faith was there. But still, comparative statement when we are doing, when we are thinking about that king in South India, he is Kshatriya. He is not Brahman. So Sanatana Goswami wanted to prove that it not that Sanatana Goswami wanted to prove not that he was Brahman, so Brahman can get first priority, not that. Sanatana Goswami wanted to speak by comparative statement here. Though he was Brahman, but the quality of this king, he is Kshatriya, is more than that Brahman. There is. Follow what I say. See, irrespective of, you know, caste and creed, Hari Bhakti, Hari Bhakta, we'll have to discuss this point. You know, we'll have to discuss this point. Gradually we are going to go up to show the excellent bhakti, gradually. So comparative saying, we find the bhakti shown by this king in South India is more than that Brahman who was flowing Varnasam Dharma there in, you know. So this way, bhakti by bhakti we know seva. Bhajadatu, when we are using this bhakti, this word means seva. Shuddha bhakti is sarupato bhagavat seva. Shuddha bhakti is nothing, but by sarup it is bhagavat seva. But in front of everybody, it cannot manifest same way. According to the desire, vasana, it can differ. Maybe their desire is pure. Mane, follow. Prahlad Maharaj having this kind of bhakti, Dhruva Maharaj having this kind of bhakti, Yudhishthira Maharaj having bhakti, always has some speciality, differ. According to their pure desire, it differ. Though by the mercy of Bhakta and Bhagavan, one can attain bhakti, still, it is also a big factor. One sadhak, those who are doing sadhan, at present sanskar and previous sanskar, according to the degree of purity of their previous sanskar and present sanskar, there is varieties of bhakti, can, you know, it differ, not same. Sadhya Vishnu Bhakti can be divided into two parts. One is Shuddha Bhakti, one is Vidya Bhakti. One is Shuddha Bhakti, another is Vidya Bhakti, means not pure Bhakti. Shuddha Sadhya Vishnu Bhakti can give satisfaction to Supreme Lord Vishnu. Shuddha Sadhya Vishnu Bhakti is meant for the satisfaction of Vishnu Sukhoika Tatparja, only target. But Vidya Bhakti, if the Vidya means some contamination there, Bhauvidha Vasana Mishram, there can be so many contamination of different desire. So it can search some personal benefit or personal satisfaction, it depends. It's called Vidya Bhakti. But about pure Bhakti, there is no other way. Only way, Bhaktya Sanjataya Bhaktya. Bhakti can give bhakti. In the way of bhakti sadhan, there is no other thing. Bhakti can give bhakti. Follow. Bhaktya sanjataya bhakta. Only bhakti can give bhakti. Only bhakti can give bhakti, nothing else. So it's called Shuddha Bhakti. Bhakti can give bhakti. Now actually Parikshit Maharaj is going to, you know, Naradji Maharaj was speaking, glorifying that, you know, king. Now Parikshit Maharaj going to speak that tattat vistarjo kathayan asrishan bhupatim muhu prasasangsa gunano gayan Binaya Vaishnavattamaha. Follow. Vaishnavattamaha. Parikshit Maharaj speaking. Vaishnavattamaha. The great Vaishnava Naraji Maharaj going to glorify all the qualities of that king and going to embrace the king repeatedly and going to play on musical instrument. Bina is going to sing the glories of king. prasangsa karte lagren. Parikshit Maharaj now speaking that tat tat vistarjo, vistarj mane propagating, glorifying, going to glorify all the qualities of that Brahman, I mean that king, South Indian king. So Parikshit Maharaj speaking, ye tat tat vistarjo kathayan naslishan bhupatim mahu prasasansa gunano gayan vinaya vaishnavattama. Vaishnavattama, Naraji Maharaj, great Vaishnav, going to glorify all the qualities of that king and going to embrace him repeatedly, going to play on musical instrument this way. He's very happy, Naraji Maharaj. Sarvabhauma manivaram sampujyam sampujyo. Sarvabhauma manivaram sampujyo pasrita abhubrit. Sarvabhauma, I mean that king who is enjoying sovereignty. Sarvabhauma, that king, going to worship that Muni, Naraji Maharaj. Sarvabhauma Munivaram Sampujya Pasrita Abhavrita. Pasrita means very humbly. Very humbly. Pasrita Abhavrita. After hearing the glory, after hearing personal glories, he was feeling very shy. He was feeling very shy. He was feeling very shy. Going to shrug his head, going to bend his head, and going to worship that Muni, Naraji Maharaj, and going to speak very humbly. Sarvabhauma Munivaram Sampujya Pasrita Abhavrit. Abhavrit mane, Abhavrit passage was actually passed, already told. Abhavrit. Sarvabhauma Munivaram Sampujya Pasrita Abhavrit. By humble attitude, by very humble mood, he was feeling shy because Naraji Maharaj going to glorify his own qualities. He was feeling very shy for that. Nijo slagya bharajato lajja namita mastaka. Going to bend his head very humbly, going to feel shy. And very humbly he is going to speak very, very softly. What he is going to speak? This is called humbleness. Amani manod haile kirtane adhikar dibe tumi. In kirtan, Bhaktivinoda is speaking. If I am going to give glories to others, glorify others, not interested to take any personal glories. No. Amani manod haile kirtane. Then Bhagavan can give power to sing glories. Follow. Then and only then Bhagavan can give power to sing the glories of, transcendental qualities of, Dham, Nam, Guru, Vaishnav, or Bhagavan. All can give power. Otherwise not. Amani manodo haile kirtane adhikaro dibe. Vastav, original sankirtan. Guru Vaishnav cannot tolerate if anybody going to insult Guru Vaishnav, that Guru Vaishnav cannot tolerate. Guru Vaishnav cannot tolerate if somebody going to insult pure Guru Vaishnav. They can give fitting answer. This is not going to break Tinadapi. Try to understand. When somebody who is false ego, out of his opulence of this, that, a big preacher going to insult Gauri or Guru Vaishnava, if some Vaishnava going to give answer, fitting answer, it is not going to break Trinadavi Bhava. It is actually Trinadavi Bhava. Prabhupada speaking, it is actually Trinadavi. To protect the glories of Guru Vaishnava, if you speak very hard against those who are going to speak all rubbish against pure Guru Vaishnava, it is not Agal Vaishnava Parad. It is bhakti. Prabhupada speaking, yes, it is bhakti. But personally, if somebody is going to insult him, he is not going to respond. Okay, you have your right to insult me. I have no objection. But if somebody is going to insult Guru Vaishnava, he can give very fitting answer. Try to understand. Now here this humble attitude, that king that great king is going to feel sigh because Narada ji going to glorify his own qualities. He don't like to hear. He feels sigh. Then that king going to speak, going to request to Narada ji, Devar sir, alpayusam, salpaisarjam, alpapradam naram, you know, asatantram, bhayakrantam, tapatrayo, niyantritam. What all glorification done by Narada Muni, one by one, out of humble attitude, king going to give answer. You going to glorify me? You going to glorify me? But it is not, you know, it's not going to suit, then going to fit. You know, your glorification not going to fit. Yeah. I cannot hear. Because here they were say, you should think that we are human being. Our life is unstable. Devar say, hey, Devar say, alpayusham. Human being, they are going to be an unstable life. Unstable life. Hey, Devar say, what kind of, you know, appliances I have? First point is that I am human being. So I am a man, and the life is very unstable. And my appliances, how much appliances I have? Devar sir, alpayushan, salpai sarjam alpapradam, naram. He Devar sir, why you are going to glorify a fallen soul like me? He Devar sir, why you are without, you know, without judgment, you are going to glorify me? I am a fallen soul, I am a human being. Without, you know, you try to calculate, you know, you try to, you know, think, how I can become Krishna Patra? You going to think that I am Krishna Kripa Patra? How you can think, Devar sir? First point, I am a human being, fallen soul. How I can become the Kripa Patra of Krishna, Sri Krishna? We are human being. Our life is unstable, very small, you know, duration of our life. And I such a appliance you have, what kind of appliance you have, I have? Eh? What kind of appliances you think, you see? Nothing. And what kind of donation I can give? Brahman, Vaishnav, Sannyasi, Anna. What kind of appliances we have? What kind of alpadata? We are going to give donation, but it's also limited. Very limited. Also, our activities, all our activities are under the control of karma dhin. We are going to get the result of our karma. This is our status. Also full of fear. Bhayam dhitiya vinivishataha ishat apatasya vipari. If we forget something about Supreme Lord, then fear can attack us. What is fear? Fear can attack us. Bhayam. Our life is full of danger. Our life is full of danger, vayakranta. And we are afflicted by the three modes of nature, satarajatama. Sometimes we become, you know, sick. Some disease develop. So what kind of, you know, kripa you have seen in me? What kind of kripa you have seen in me? So that you can claim that I am Vishnu Kripa Patra, Krishna Kripa Patra. What kind of influences I have? Very limited. And what kind of donation we can see? Well, specially our life is, you know, controlled by karma, karma paradhin, controlled by a karma fal, full of fear all the time. If we forget Supreme Lord for the time, then immediately the fear can attract. We are afflicted by the three modes of nature. Satarajatama. Sometimes you have, you know, growing disease inside our body. No satisfaction, nothing there in our life. Even in dream, I cannot think that I am the Kripa Patra of Krishna, how, hey Munivar, you are great, elevated soul, even now. That's why naturally you are going to glorify me. It is your nature. It is your nature that you are always going to glorify. That's why you are doing. It is not your fault, but you should think, there is nothing. There is nothing in my life so that you can glorify. Devar ser alpayusham salpai sarjam alpapradam naram asatantram bhayakrantam tapatraya nyantritam. So what all glorification done by Naraji Maharaj, that king going to pass away. King going to give some excuse, going to give some documents that Naraji Maharaj, you are great king, it is your nature that you are going to glorify. So without thinking, you are glorifying me. So I am not at all kipapatra Vishnu. Krishna anugraha bakasya upi ayogyam avicharataha. Even if we think, even in dream we cannot think. I cannot think that I am Krishna Kipapatra. Tadiyo Koruna Patram. Krishna Kipapatra Katham Mam Mannati Bhavan. How you think that I am the Kipapatra? I am the Kipapatra of Bhagavan Sri Krishna? No. You have to think over and again. Actually, you will have to think about those demigods. Yeah. Yes. Yes, they are lucky. Hey Naraji Maharaj, those demigods staying in heaven, you can go there, you can search, you can see they are very lucky. They are actually Kipapatra. How? Argument given by the king. Deva eva Kipapatram Vishnur Bhagavataha Kila Pujyamana Narair Nityam Tejo Tejo Mayo Saririna. Their body is not completely there. Actually, the body of demigods, they are also material. But fine body. Not, their body is fine body. Like our eyes, sweat and all bad smell from body, not coming, blood and, you know, bad blood. You know, their body is not. Their body is fine body. And so, Deva eva kipa patram Vishnur Bhagavata kila. Follow. Prakritabhakya, actually, if you think that demigods, they are actually kipa patra. I deem so, I think so. Because they are always going to be worshipped. They are always going to be worshipped by human beings in this world. They are always going to be worshipped. Ganapati Devata, somebody worshipping. Somebody going to worship, you know, Durga, somebody going to worship Kartik, somebody going to worship Saraswati, Lakshmi, all different demigods. Demigods are there. So actually, all, you know, they are going to be worshipped by human beings. So, and their body is Tejomai. They have some effulgent. Their body is fine body. Tejomai. Nispa. You know, we are full of sin. There are no sin there. Actually, one by one gradation of bhakti. Then is pap. But we already know, we are going to give argument after. That Naraji Maharaj is going to do some sinful activities by killing Vishwarup. I can come to the point. Now, actually, king going to glorify those demigods, going to give comparative statement. Actually, you can go to heaven. Those demigods, they are actually Krishna Kipap. Vishnu Kiva Patra. They are going to be worshipped by human beings. Their body is not like us, bad smell, sweat coming, different kind of disease developing. We are afflicted, our body is afflicted by Satanaja Tamana thing. Their body is not like that. Tejomai, have some effulgent of their body, fine body. Nanispap, sinless, Shattagun Yukto, they are full of Satagun. And they are devoid of, you know, there is no, you know, painful experience there, dukkha rahit. They have no painful experience. They are always happy. They are always sada sukhi. They are always happy. Satchanda, they can do anything they like. They can go anywhere they like. They don't need anything. They can shah. They can go very easily. If one demigod like to reach me, very within fraction of a second reach. Follow and reach. They are always happy. Satchanda char, they can do anything they like. You know, satchanda gati, they can go anywhere without any impediments, barrier. Vishesh, especially those demigods, they are going to take care of their respective devotees. Suppose Ganapati Devata are going to take care of those who are worshipping Ganapati, those and some other groups, those who are going to worship, you know, Saraswati, and their Saraswati also going to take care of them. Follow. Mutual interest. Especially, they are going to take care of their respective group of devotees. Upon upon Bhakta Vargiroti, Slagito, they are going to bless them also. We know that Digvijayi Pandit, you know, from Chaitanya Bhagavat Chaitanya Charitamrita, that Digvijayi Pandit coming in front of Mahaprabhu, I am not going in details, but there we see that Digvijayi Pandit going to get the full blessing of material Saraswati. Not transcendental Saraswati, Aprakita Saraswati, Vishnu Priya Devi. The Dushta Saraswati, wicked Saraswati. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes in Kirtan, na? Jaravidya jato mayar vaibhav, Jaravidya jato mayar vaibhav, tomar bhajane badha, amit anitya sansare moha janmiya jipke gorai kadha, gadha. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing in Kirtan. Jaravidya, material education, ultimately can make a man ass. Ass mean, ass always like to get some burden on backside, backbone, on back. So Bhaktivinoda writing, all material education going to make you an ass. Ultimately you are going to take burden, a material burden. Jaravidya jato mayar vaibhav, it is the opulence of maya, material education. Material education is nothing. It is not actually vidya. Sa vidya tat matir jaya. Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving answer to Uddhav Ji Maharaj. That is called actually vidya. By the help of which you can develop bhakti unto a lotus feet of Bhagavan. Sa vidya tat matir jaya. By the help of that vidya, if you can develop bhakti unto a lotus feet of Supreme Lord, that is called actually vidya. Otherwise it is not vidya. Sa vidya tat jap matir jaya. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, material education can ultimately make a man ass. Jara vidya jato mayar vaibhav, tomar bhajane badha, anitya sansare moha janmiya. Infatuation, attraction you can create and can divert you from your Atma Mangal, the track of Atma Mangal. You can forget the track of Atma Mangal, you can go to some opposite way. Follow. Mahaprabhu ultimately speaking to that Digvijayi Pandit. Digvijayi means he is going to get certificate from, he is going to take certificate from different place that I am enjoying victory. Follow. Digvijayi. Different place he is going. And going to take certificate from different pandit that he is a great pandit, nobody can defeat him. It's called certificate. It's called Digvijayi Pandit. Now Digvijayi Pandit when meet Mahaprabhu, ultimately Mahaprabhu wanted to make him understand. Mahaprabhu wanted to say that material education, this is not the blessing. You are getting material education, na? Material education is enjoying the keep of Saraswati. So those, you know, he is enjoying the benediction by Saraswati Devi. So that Saraswati Devi going to help him to write, read, express, proficiency. But a devotee not going to help of this kind of thing. Always devotee like to get the help of Vishupriya Devi, Shuddha Saraswati, pure Saraswati. Mahaprabhu going to make him understand, it is not the result of Vidya that you can conquer the whole world. It is not the result of actual Vidya that you can go and, get the certificate from whole world that you are, topmost. What is this? Full of false ego? No. No, it's not at all. It's one kind of bondage, big bondage. So, actually now, Bhakti Chavarodaya Kaha. Those demigods, they are going to give blessing. All those demigods, they are going to give blessings and benediction to their respective groups, those who are following them. Follow. If you are going to worship Ganapati Maharaj, then surely Kartik cannot give blessing. Is that they have personal, they have some jealousy with each other. Follow. The material Saraswati, Lakshmi. Follow. So, Nispapaha, Sattika, at least they are Sattik Bhav. They have no material pain. They are very happy all the time. They can go anywhere they like. They can do anything they like. They can give benediction to their respective groups. Except respective groups, they can give. So I think they are great. Or at the same time, Jesam hi bhagya amritam mrityu roga jara di hrit. They are going to drink nectar. Follow, come on. They are going to drink nectar. So they cannot have any death. They cannot develop disease. Nothing. Sweat cannot come. They are very happy all the time. Jesam hi bhagya amritam mrityu roga jara di hrit. Hrit mane mrityu. Mrtumen, demigods, they are also those demigods, heaven is also unstable. But anyway, king going to speak, to establish respective promotional bhakti mood. We are bound to discuss. We can know that Naradji Maharaj was cursed by Gautami Muni. I am not going in details. Naradji Maharaj was cursed by Gautami Muni. Follow. And develop, big problem in his life. So they cannot develop, any problem is not, not actually, we cannot accept it. But still, for the time being, we can accept, because comparative statement, because the king is speaking more and happily, king going to glorify those demigods. They are nispapa, sattika, dukkho, rahitaha, sukhi, naha, sada, satchanda, satchanda, charagatayu, bhakti, cha, varadaya, kaha. After that speaking, Parikshit Maharaj speaking actually, that king going to speak that way in front of Naraji. Jesam hi bhagyam ritam. They are drinking nectar. So no question of death, no disease, no problem, nothing. Ar sechayopanatam kutido bada abhave opitushtidam. They are not going to beg anything from anybody. If somebody is going to arrange jagya share, they are going to get the share. Om Varunaya Swaha, Indraya Saha. They are going to, then they are going to get their respective share. Otherwise they are drinking Amrita, they are not feeling appetite, they are not feeling hungry. They are drinking na, they are drinking Amrita. Jesam hi bhagyamritam mrityu roga jara hridi jara jara dihirt. No question of death, no disease, nothing, you know, no problem. Asechayapagatam. Without expectation, if somebody is going to send some share of jagya, sechayopanatam, kuttiro badha abhave opitushtitam. Kuttiro badha abhave. There is no impediments. Human being always, you know, hungry, feeling tired, feeling, you know, sick, this way. But there is no question, you know. That's comparatively, the demigods, they are very happy. You can go there and see their situation. I think they are very happy. Basanti Bhagavan Sarge Mahabhagyo Balenache. They are very lucky. They are very lucky they are staying in heaven. They are very lucky we are staying in material world. Anytime there's kind of material disaster, anytime material disaster like flood, and a cyclone can come, earthquake, any kind of problem can, but in heaven there's no problem. Eh? Basanti Bhagavan Sarge Maha Bhagya Balena Je. Eh? Those demigods, they are staying in heaven, there's no problem. Very lucky. Jo nivir bharate varse sat punnair labhate kirtvai. Only and only in India, only and only in Bharat Varsha, those are falling actual, you know, Varnasam Dharma accident, they are falling to, by their pious activities, they can attain Sarga. By their pious activities, they can attain Sarga. Basanti Bhagavan Sarge Mahabhagyo Balenaje, by their luck, very, very lucky they are. Only human being after falling, you know, some, you know, karma vissa bhakti, anything they are falling, you know, gyan karma, anything they are doing. In Bharatvasa, if they are falling varnasam dharma properly, then by their pious activities they can reach. Follow. By their pious activities where they are going to gather, because when they are going to arrange prasadam for outside people, that punno, they are going to collect punno. Somebody is going to distribute water among public in Vrindavan, you can go. Everywhere you can find somebody arrange a water tank. They are going to provide cold water to all, you know, pedestrian, those who are doing parikram, going to arrange. Somewhere you can find they are arranging prasadam for outside people. They can come and take if they feel hungry, they can come. But, you know, by their past activities, they can reach. Rantidev was doing this kind of karma vissa bhakti, but here his attention was towards Bhagavan. He was not at all ready to take punya, pious activity. It was not pious activities. Rantidev was also allowing his prasadam, water, everything, what kind of problem Jivatma feeling is going to solve. But his mood was totally different. Rantidev was always thinking, I am serving Supreme Lord Paramatma in the form of Jivas. There is no second desire. That's why his karma misra bhakti was successful. He could realize Bhagavat Tattva. Follow. Basanti Bhagavan Sarge Mahabhagya Balena Je. Yo nivir bharate varse, only is India, those who are doing pious activities, they can reach that heaven. But some limited period, not for infinity period. Because heavenly planet is not going to get the stability for infinity period. So no question. Even Brahma is not, you know, when Hiranyakashipu is going to ask, I want to be immortal. Mama is thinking, I am not, I am also going to, I am also mortal. Mortality is also there with me. How can I make you immortal? Not possible. So excuse me, if you have something, you can ask. That kind of benediction I can arrange, but this benediction I cannot give. But I don't have personally. So those who are going to reach heaven, those who are going to reach heaven, okay, they can stay in heaven for some period. After that, in Gita it is written, Khine punne mattolokam viśanti. Khine punne, when your punna, pious activity is deposit, like you are going to a 5-star hotel, you'll have to pay immediately, initial price, you have to pay honey. Then you are allowed to enter your room, anything you can do. But while you are going away, you'll have to pay the rest amount, otherwise they cannot allow you to go. Follow. They cannot allow you to stay, they can hand over to police. They can call police. Follow this way. So, khine punne mattalakam viśanti. When the deposit money mean here, deposit punna, pious activity, deposited pious activities all finished, then those demigods, they can push you down, they can throw you down in this material world. This is the status. This is the status of reaching heavenly planet. Everybody like to, after death they like to reach heaven. Foolish number one. They don't like to search the eternity. They don't like to enter eternal world. They don't like to do Krishna bhajan. They are less interested. Now, king going to glorify demigods this way. Then, king going to speak, Mune, Visishtahastatrapi tesham indra purandaraha nigruhe anugruhe opi isho vrishtivhir loko jivanaha. He Naraji Maharaj, he Muni, he Munivar, he great sage, he great Muni. There is some speciality also with Purandar, I mean Indra. I am glorifying as a whole those who are staying in heavenly planet, all demigods. But out of them, specially, I like to speak about Indra. He is enjoying full power. He has controlling over all demigods. He is a ruler. He is a ruler of heavenly planet. Some special power can give punishment and give, he can arrange some facility also, give punishment and give, presentation also. Nigruhe anugruhe opi isho. Also, Indra going to get control over the reigning in the material world. Indra going to give reign in this material world. So all, human beings, they can get the facility to get rain drops in the field. They can grow crops. They can, lead their life accordingly. If there is no crop, if there is no rain, how they can, So Indra is very important personality. Among all demigods, Mune visishtastatrapi tesam Indra purandaraha nigruhe anugruhe opi isho. Brishtivhir loko jivanaha. He is going to maintain the life of the material world. If there is no rain, who can live? Big problem can be there. Also, he has controlling over Trilokishwarata yasso yuganam ekasaptatim and jasya ashwamedha sati napi sarvabhauma sadurlabha. Hey Munivar, try to think about Indra. He has done hundreds of shatakratu ashwamedh yajna. Shatakratu, hundreds. Nobody, Prithu Maharaj wanted to break the record.
But there was jealousy. I can come to the point. Now, actually, we can think about favorable points, what king going to speak. After that, we can gradually, one by one, we can cut the Siddhanta and speak. No, they are not at all. Gradually, you can go up and up regarding bhakti. Follow what I say. So, Tilakishwarata, he is controlling over this material world, heaven and hell, just so, and he is going to rule over 71 Chaturyuga. Follow. One by one, Ekatta Chaturyug, 71. I can explain next day, today no time. Tilakishwarata jasso yuganam eka saptatim. Follow. Ekata chaturjug gone, one manantar, like 14 manantar, 14 manantar gone, then Brahma one 12 hours. Brahma going to get 12 hours gone, din, daytime. Similarly night time. So you cannot conceive. He cannot calculate. Impossible. Follow what I say. Trilokishwarata. He is going to enjoy the sovereignty over this material planet in heaven and hell also. Sargamattu patal. Patal means down. Trilokishwarata jasso yuganam ekasaptatim. 71 cycle of Chaturyuga. Is going to live. Oh my God! And jasho meda satenapi. Nobody could break up to now. Up to now, nobody could break the record that Naraji Maharaj, actually, Indra Maharaj, he was successful to do 100 satokrutu ashwamedh yajna. Prithu Maharaj was about to cross the limit. Prithu Maharaj wanted to break the record, but there was disturbance, there was jealousy. Indra wanted to make disturbance. Ultimately, Bhagavan requesting to Prithu Maharaj, what it concerns to you? What you can do with Jagya? Eh? Let Indra have the record, final record to have 100. What it concerns to you? Eh? Excuse him. Don't be worried with that. You are no fighting soon. No, okay. Out of jealousy, Indra Maharaj wanted to make disturbance in the 100th number of Jagya. When 99 Jagya was successful, when Prithu Maharaj was wanted to arrange the 100th number Jagya, Indra wanted to make so many disturbance, what to speak. All black history, you see. Black record. Jealousy everywhere. Even though sadhus, they ask jealousy, Maharaj. And if your target is Bhagavan, why you are expressing jealousy? I like to send you in front of Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, Kesava Goswami Maharaj. I know you go and hear them. I always expressing all different kind of glories of different Vaishnavas. I cannot hide it. Eh? Great devotee. Who never wanted to claim that I am a preacher, Sadananda Prabhu. But I can prove he is the number one preacher, topmost preacher. He never going here and there. I am a great preacher, not speaking. Great preacher. Ordinary man, they cannot understand his mood. Oh, so nice, high class writing. Enjoying full kippa Prabhupada. That is a symptom. That is a symptom that he is enjoying full kippa of Prabhupada. He never wanted to get personal pratishtha. He wanted to establish Gauriya Siddhanta. All the jewels Siddhanta Ratna Prabhupada he wanted to represent. Never wanted to, get pratishtha. So this way, countless, maybe Madhav Goswami are not going outside. So what? So they are not teacher? What do you mean to say? Here, Madhav Goswami Maharaj, nobody going to forest in Assam. Nobody going to preach in Punjab. a Mayavad field. Madhav Goswami is going to give his whole life for preaching. He is not preacher. What do you mean to say? Only those who are going to preach in foreign gate, they are preacher. What do you mean to say? Foolish. Sanatan Rup not going foreign gate. So they are not preacher. What do you mean to say? Preaching mean? Preaching mean to get established in acharan of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Idealism. It is called preaching. Massive preaching, massive preaching. Foolish number one. What do you mean by massive preaching? You can sow, you can give bhakti to one mandeso, you can break if they are going to develop some, you know, basic saddha, you are going to break. Don't go to Sam Baba. Oh, no, no, don't go. Oh, very good. You can also get punishment. I need not play my head. Nobody like to allow you to hear pure Harikatha. Nobody allow you to hear, attain the pure sadhu. Oh, no, go there. Don't go there. Politics. Why need to go and join political party? Why are you coming to do bhajan? Always busy with personal profit and loss. So, now the king speaking is enjoying the sovereignty of Sargamatta Patal. And 71 Chatur Yuga, cycle of Chatur Yuga went to leave. And nobody could break, up to now, nobody could break the record of 100 Satakrati Yajna. So I think it's a great. Yasya meda sati napi sarvabhauma sa sudurlava. It's durlava. Sorry, not sudurlava. It's durlava. Sorry. Sudurlava mean, meaning can change. Sorry. Jashasya meda sati napi sarvabhauma sa durlava. Follow. And hayo uchisrava yaso gajo airavato mahan kamadhuko gaurur gaurupovanam nandanancho virayate. Follow, what is it? They are going to get the help of that uchisrava. After the churning of that kira, after churning that kira ocean, there was uchisrava, one special horse, first came. First came poison, after that one by one, uchisrava, vairavat, elephant, all, you know. Follow, what I say? Kamdhuga gabhi, kamdhenu, you can get in heaven. Nandan Kanan, heavenly garden there, Nandan Kanan, he is all enjoying these facilities. King going to proclaim that you are glorifying me. If you know about Indra, if you go and see the affluence of the Indra, he is enjoying full, you know, so nice there. Then you cannot glorify me. If you go and check up, Mune, Vishishtastatrapi, Tesham Indraha Purandaraha Nigrahe Anugrahe Opi Isha Brishtivir Lok Jivanaha Trilokishwarata Yaso Yuganam Ekasaptatim Jasvameda Sati Napi Sarvabhumasa Durlava Hayo Uchisrava Yaso Gajo Airavata Mahan Kamadhuko Gau Rupobanam Nandanancha Virajati. All different kind of facility is going to enjoy. Oh, Naraji Maharaj, oh great king, you are going to glorify me. I feel sigh. I feel sigh. Man is mortal. Any time can die. There is no, at least demigod, they are going to enjoy as long period of their life. Actually, king going to proclaim that way, actually there is also limitation of life there. Lifespan is also limited, but still, Naraji Maharaj speaking, they are going to live 71, very long life. They have power, effulgence, their body is effulgence, fine body. They are not developing any disease or, you know, nothing can there. So, better you can go and check up the glories of demigods, especially
He can go and, you know, you can see Naraji Maharaj who is having great affluences there. Great affluences. And also different kind of facilities there. Uchchasava special horse on the Airavad elephant going to, you know, Indra going to take the help of Uchchasava horse and elephant Airavad horse. And also there is a special cows there, Kamduk. Any time Kamaduk, those cows here Gomata is only giving milk. That also on time. Not you asking milk can give, not that. Here cows they can give milk, but there's some condition. But they are actually those cows there, Kamduga. Anything you ask, that Kamduga Gavi, anything you demand, that Kamdhenu can give you. His name is Kamdhenu. Kamdhenu, according to your demand, they can fulfill. Follow what I say. Parshuram, his father, Jamadagni Muni, he has Kamduk money, Kamduk Gau. You can remember. Or I have to remind you. Jamadagni Muni, the father Parshuram, in his ashram, there was one Kamdhenu guy. Kamdhenu guy, if you ask, oh Kamdhenu ma, you give me rice, he can give rice. You give me gold, he can give gold. Give sabji, he can give sabji. Anything you demand. So when Kartavijja Arjun, with his full troops, went to the ashram of Jamadagni Muni. That Jamadagni Muni wanted to give the honor to the king with the help of this Kamduk Muni. He wanted to arrange, give hospitality. He wanted to arrange hospitality, give us all, you know, puri, sabji, all sweet ball, everything, all around. Big bandara was there. Now Kartavijja Arjun was thinking, are he is a penniless, you know, rishi. Where from he is getting this kind of appliances? Now he is searching. Oh, now finally you find, there is a great property here. Come, Dhenu, Gomata. Oh, now I see. Oh, I need this Kamdhenu. Oh, what a rishi can do. What use? Kamaduga, the Kamdhenu guy, that Gomata, I need. This is a penniless rishi. What he can do? He's staying in forest. Better I can take. Jamadagni Muni requesting king. King, don't do this kind of wrong activities. Don't do this kind of sinful activities. Please, don't do. I honored you. I give you hospitality, everything. Now you are going to take undue advantage. You wanted to take this cow. And that Kamdhenu Gomata, she is also crying. But forcefully, that king out of his manpower, going to take away that cow. What to do? Jamadagni Muni crying. All, you know. But that time, Parshuram was not there. When Parshuram come back, take information, that a Kamdhenu guy, Gomata, was taken away. Oh, really? So much audacity. Let me see what I can do. Then with hackshaw, going to reach that kingdom and going to cut Kartavijja Arjun into pieces. Going to cut the body of Kartavijja. One by one hand, 100 hands, 1,000. Cut all. Follow. After that, when Parshuram was not there, gone to some forest, that all the sons of the Kartavijja Arjun, they wanted to take revenge against the murder of their father. Now coming secretly, going to cut the throat of Jamadagni Muni. Then Renuka, the wife of Jamadagni Muni, the mother of Parshuram, crying, Oh Ram, you come and see the situation here. Then Parshuram,
from long distance can hear, but the demigods, they have demigods and also Parshuram also have power. They have some basic power. They can hear from thousands of miles away. If I request from here, then one demigods can hear. If I can request from here in this material world, that request can reach, they can hear if I call them. This is a facility that is called some yogic facility. They can reach anywhere without time. They can get vanish in front of you. This is called all the powers of yoga. So Parshuram also, when mother crying from long distance, here, oh, my mother crying, immediately crying, coming here and found my father is lying there in a pool. He was found in a pool of blood. His father was found in a pool of blood. His father was found in a pool of blood, and throat was cut off. And his throat was totally off from the body, beheaded. Oh my God. So you see, Kamdhenu can fulfill the desire of those who are staying in heavenly planet. They can, anybody going to ask anything, Kamdhenu Mata can give. This is an extra facility thing. So I can discuss about this point. What the king wanted to speak, then gradually we can go on and cutting one by one. Siddhanta going to establish. There is also no stability. There is also we cannot get any stability of bhakti, nothing. We can go further. So for the time being, we'll have to stop today. Next week, due to net problems, so many problems of Harikatha, I couldn't speak. I wanted to die because I couldn't speak. I was feeling very sorry all the time. Jasyasti bhaktir bhagavati akinchana sarva gunai statro samasati suraha haro abhaktasya kuto mahod gunaha manoratin asato dhavato vahi vancha kalpaduru sikhe basindu bhavacha patitanam pavanu bhavishnu vyo namo namo.